Amazon is going to be installing my home charger for my Audi e-tron?
That's right.
So Amazon is Audi e-tron, I should say.
Proverbial Audi e-tron. Well, so Amazon is going to use what it calls its home services division to do installation of these chargers. And home services is one that actually, if I confess, I've not ever used before, because it's one of these things for infrequent big purchases, things you might only do once or twice in a home's lifetime, like a refrigerator or a washing machine or a home charger. So what this is doing is removing quite a bit of the friction out of doing something that you don't do that often. So it's an intriguing way to just simplify a process. You might know what charger you want. In fact, I'm sure that Audi would have a preferred set of chargers that's there for any given e-tron purchaser. This just simplifies the process of getting somebody in the home, having them take care of the paperwork, and having them do all the connection for you.
What is the significance of this for Amazon, assuming this is only a teeny tiny little sliver of their business, and for Tesla, for which this is a huge part of their business?
Right. So it's a good question. I'll take the Tesla part first. So for Tesla, and I gave a little talk about this last week at a big conference in London, it was essentially existential, right? You had this chicken and egg problem. You can build great cars, but without a network, you can't really charge them up. And without a bunch of chargers, you're not going to sell a lot of cars. So what Tesla did is simply build the network first. You know, for Amazon, this is far, far different from that, in the sense that I doubt this would be materially significant even in any given decade in the future. But what it's intriguing for to me is that it's sort of getting Amazon into the home in yet another way.
And it's got an intriguing angle.
Yep.
You don't think this could become a much bigger business for Amazon?
So I went with a little thought experiment on it myself, which was, you know, last week, or a couple weeks ago rather, Amazon released a whole slew of new Alexa connected gadgets, and one of them was a microwave. And what struck me about that is that it simplifies a process that is full of menus, options, opaque attempts to do something, and replaces it with just, Alexa, there's a slice of pizza in there, heat it up for me. And my thinking was, electric charging is another thing very similar to that. It's got a lot of latency in it, in the sense that you've got some time involved. There's a bunch of decisions you might need to make to optimize, but you probably don't want to do. And my thinking was, let's say that Amazon rolls out its own charger in the future. And let's say you just drive in there, plug in, and say, Amazon, I'm not going out, or Alexa, I'm not going out tonight, charge me up. And then let's imagine further that it's, say, all you want charging just as part of your Prime account or something like that.